actually did my elementary school years right outside of Boston here in Easton, Massachusetts. So it's kind of like coming home, but if it's a home that you've never been to before because you don't recognize anything, then it's been 40 years since you've been there. So it's good to be back. I lost the accent a long time ago, but I actually haven't heard a lot of accent today, so I think you guys are pretty much a melting pot around here now, and everybody's got their own little voice, which I think is wonderful. So today, we're going to talk about using a WordPress product for good. I am a Wonder Woman fan. I have everything in my office Wonder Woman. I have the Wonder Woman shades, which I would wear for the whole talk if I could see, but I told you I moved right here 40 years ago. I'm going to be 50 years old this year, so I actually need the readers to be able to see a little bit better. But what I love is if afterwards you want to come up, take a picture with the glasses and tweet it out and tag my business, that would be awesome because I would love to see you all on Twitter with my glasses on. So we're going to put those right there, and I hope to see some of you right after the talk. So using your WordPress powers for good. So my name is Michelle Ames. I said I'm from Rochester, New York. Flew in yesterday morning. It was awesome. It's only a 6-hour drive, so knowing that and seeing how beautiful the city is, I will probably be back again. This has been lovely, and it's been nice to meet you all here today. All the slides will be available on slideshare.net later, too, so if there's anything that you want to see, the last slide will give you a little bit more information about that. So what's the wonderful thing to me over the 5 years that I've been using WordPress, maybe 6 years I've been using WordPress, is watching it grow from about 22% of the internet to almost 30% of the internet that we know, we can tell what they're using is actually powered by WordPress. That's huge. That is humongous. Can we take a minute and just kind of appreciate how big a number that is? It's a tremendously powerful resource. I see people at WordCamps all over the United States and Canada. I'm meeting people constantly in my own meetup in my own hometown and see the impact that WordPress is having on the world. And I think it's a wonderful thing. We're using it to build businesses. We're using it to build nonprofits. We're using it to power really good things. It's free. It was a gift to us. WordPress itself is free. It's a huge gift. But what do we do with a gift like that? Well, the first thing we do is we don't re-gift it, but we kind of do re-gift it, right? Because it's the gift that keeps on giving. It's like when you light a candle and then you light somebody else's candle, your candle doesn't go out. So you can use WordPress and give WordPress and everybody gets to keep using it. What do we do with it? We build websites. Everybody in here built a website? Raise your hand if you built a website using WordPress. Fantastic. Raise your hand if this is your first time and you're still learning. That's fantastic. I love that too because it's a great resource. I was a newbie one time. I bought a URL. I had used WordPress. I said to a friend of mine, I said, so how do I get from owning a domain name to having WordPress on the site? And his response was, you install it. Okay, take a few steps back and explain to me, what does you install it mean? And so he and his wife had 5 kids. He said, if she was working that night, he said, if you come over and cook dinner for the kids, I'll teach you how to install WordPress on a website. I said, golden, I'm making spaghetti for everybody. So I went over, I made spaghetti for everybody. He showed me the download, change your config file, re-upload. He showed me the long, hard way to do it so that I'd have a good understanding and appreciation of what that WP config file looked like. And then I would have an understanding. He says, you can use the one button install once you understand how this works. And as a result of that day, I have a much better understanding of how WordPress works and why it works that way. So we build websites with WordPress. And as you can see there, sometimes they're really, really bad websites. This was one of the first websites I did. I had decided I was going to quit my job working in higher education, and I was going to put my MBA in marketing to use. And I was going to build a marketing company, and I was going to build websites for people, and I was going to make lots of money doing it. So I get a phone call, my first phone call, I'm like, oh, this is exciting. It's a new potential client. She says, how much do you charge for a website? And I thought, $300. Because I thought I could build 3 websites a week and I could be rolling in dough. Okay, so let's take a step back from that too. Because number one, $300 was not enough money to build a website. And number two, I can't build 3 websites a week. I don't know what I was thinking. I knew I could kind of build the infrastructure or something. It takes a lot more to build a website, right? I can't power out 3 in a week. I'm not a machine. So sometimes they're bad. So she says to me, oh, but it's going to be an e-commerce website. I said, oh, well, that changes it. $500. And she said, I want it to look just like this other website, which was a site I managed but hadn't built. And I thought, oh, that's easy. I know the theme. I know how the content is built. So I used that theme and I built her website. And she said, well, that's not exactly what I want. Let me tell you that what she ended up with was a 180-degree turn from what she told me she wanted. Because as we worked through the process together, it morphed and it morphed and it morphed, and the scope creep on that project got huge. I probably put into that site over the course of a year over 100 hours for $500. That's not enough. Minimum wage was more than that at the time, and I was building websites for less than minimum wage. So, and as much as I put in, I paid for that website in my education, but I learned so much. And yes, she got an absolutely horrible website that I didn't know how to build. I was using a paid theme, but she needed this tweaked and that tweaked, and so it still exists, believe it or not. Somebody else said to me, she wanted me to do some more things, and I said, well, actually, I work for a full-time job now, so I have this other person that I can recommend to you. And I called the other person, I said, do you want the most difficult client in the world? And she said, I'll take anything. I said, you can have her. And so this is actually the site I built, managed by somebody else. And I will be 100% honest and say this is a really, really bad website. But guess what? I still make a little bit of money. At $5 an hour, but I still made a little bit of money. Because even the bad websites we build can still make us a little bit of money, right? And let me tell you that 5 years later, I'm building much better websites. I just want you to know that I'm charging more than $300 than I do. So I have grown as a designer. But we make money. What else do? We have fun. I don't know about you, but when I publish that website and I turn it on public, I feel like I just earned my wings. Like little bells go off and angels sing and whatever, because it's exciting. It's fun. It's exciting to show the world. Post it on Facebook, realize that I forgot to set a featured image, go back and repost it on Facebook 10 minutes later. Because that's how it works, right? Because it's 3 o'clock in the morning and I forgot to do that one last little thing. Nobody else has ever done that, right? Please raise your hand and tell me that you've made little mistakes too. Okay. So yes, we have fun with it. Even working alone as I did for years, I had fun with it. Because I was talking to people, I was out in the community, I was doing things that were fun. Now maybe we should do more than just make money and have a little bit of fun with it. There's more that we can do with WordPress. So let's talk about paying it forward a little bit. We can mentor people. So somebody mentored me. I made spaghetti dinner. He taught me how to install a WordPress site. He mentored me into it. He showed me what it was like to build a WordPress website. When I have questions, I still call him and he will give me answers. He doesn't charge me for that because he mentored me. I have mentored other people. This is Amanda. In this picture, Amanda graduated high school with my daughter. Amanda called me up one day and she said, you build websites, can you give me a little advice? I said, sure, what kind of website are you building? She said, HTML. I said, well, my first advice is change to WordPress. And she said, what's WordPress? And I said, oh, honey, let's get together. And so we spent a couple hours in my office and I showed her WordPress. It opened up her world. She was on fire that night about how much she could do with WordPress. Similar to how I was once I figured out how to get it on my URL. It was exciting. She was excited. That was about 8 years ago. She and I are still such good friends that I married her to her husband last fall. And we have grown and become much better friends. I hired her. And she works for me now at the company that I work for, which I'm going to talk about a little bit later, how I got the job where I am. So I've been mentoring her. I mentor other people. I take on one person a year. Take them under my wing. Sometimes it's for an internship at their college. Sometimes it's because they want to learn more about WordPress or about web design or marketing. I mentor people because people did that for me. I want to pay it forward and I want to help other people. I teach classes. So maybe you don't want to mentor somebody. Maybe you don't want somebody underfoot. Maybe you don't have that kind of time. But I bet you could find one day, a year, a quarter, whatever it is, where if you have enough WordPress knowledge, you can share that with other people. So now I teach classes. I have a class coming up a week from tomorrow. I'm teaching a bunch of people. One day class. We start in the morning, they have no idea what they're doing. By the end of the day, much to build. And they're excited and they're powered up and they're fired up. And the people that the first time I did this was last December, I had five people pay $100 to sit in a class for a full day class. I supplied the pizza, they supplied the I don't know, I supplied the I might know, and they showed up. At the end of the day, they had websites that they are now continuing to build, and those same people still come back, they have come back to our meetup, because they have got the idea of what WordPress can do for them, and they continue. So teach some classes, show people what it is that you're excited about. Now I have people say to me, why would you teach other people how to build websites? Because they're just creating competition. And I say, have you seen how many bad websites there are around the world? Those people need web designers, and I can't possibly do it all for $300 a site. I can't do it all for $5,000, $10,000 a site. There's so much need that I don't think of all the people I know that do websites and WordPress websites, and I'm talking hundreds of people, because I've been in this a while now. I have never gone up against a person I know for a site. People come to me, they either hire me or they don't. They either go on to somebody else or they don't. I have never been in the same room or the same field with a close friend where we're trying to outbid each other. There's enough clients to go around. So why not teach other people how to build good websites and charge more than $300? Maybe you don't want to teach a whole class. Maybe you can hold a clinic. So about once or twice a year, I hold a WordPress clinic. I rent a room for half a day. I get people to come in, and we talk about what's right and what's wrong with their websites. We answer questions. We look at each other's websites, and we see what could be better. And when they say, I don't know how to do XYZ, we say, have you never used the inspect element? Let me show you how to implement CSS and how to do that. And by the time they leave, they've empowered themselves to do more with their websites and have better web design. And most of them are just doing web design for their own companies, right? So they started a blog or they started a company. They're doing something that they need to show their, you know, they're selling whatever widget that they create. And so they need a website to do that. And by the end of that day, they feel better. They know how to do more with their website because we held a clinic. I don't charge people to come to those clinics. It's a half day. It's my way to give back and pay forward, to show that people can really just do a little bit more. I can donate a half a day of my time to make other people feel better. Guess what? They're not my customers. They're building their own websites. I haven't done anything to decrease how I make money. If anything, every once in a while, one of those people says, can I pay you to do it? And now I am making money out of it. Because when they feel like they're in over their head and they really just want to make widgets, it's time for somebody else to manage the website that helps them do that. And so I'm able to help them do that. And if I don't have the capacity, I find them somebody else who can. Because there's plenty of us to go around, and I don't need all the business. I can certainly share that with my other WordPressers. We also, in Rochester, have once a month coworking. So what is coworking? I'm so glad you asked. Coworking is we get together from 9 to 4 once a month, and we just all work on our own stuff in the same room. So you're working on your website, you're building a website for a client, they're starting to figure out how to build their blog, and we're all in the same space. Because most of us in WordPress work alone. How many of you work alone? More than half in the room have indicated, for those of you watching on WordPress TV, that you work alone. It gets lonely, doesn't it, working alone? You know, I work alone. I work alone for a company, but we're on Slack all day, so I'm not really alone, because I get to talk to people on Slack all day long. But even then, it's still like just me in my pajamas or whatever, working at home on myself. So when I have these co-working days, and I'm in a room with 10 people, it's awesome, because I feed on that. The energy in that room and the creativity in that room is awesome, and guess what? It kind of turns into a little bit of a clinic. Hey, Michelle, do you know how to do this? Hey, Michelle, do you have a plugin that will do that? Do you know anything that can do XYZ or anybody who has done ABC? And so it turns into this awesome ability for us to exchange ideas and help one another out. And somebody will say, hey, Michelle, I don't know why I'm the authority of the room, but it's always, hey, Michelle. Probably because I run the local or manage the local WordPress community in Rochester as far as our meetups. But it's like, hey, Michelle, do you have a plugin that will do XYZ? And I'm like, no, I don't. But guess what? Sarah in the bathroom goes, hey, I know how to do that. And so at the end of the day, we've all been working on our own projects, but helping each other too. Co-working is an amazing way to do that. So we usually find a space at a college or a library. Sometimes we just meet for a couple hours at a coffee shop and help each other out. So we do organized co-working. We do just just kind of like drop everything and co-work. I haven't actually turned that into a URL yet, so dropeverythingatcowork.com is available. It's mine. You can have it. I got enough. Who else just collects URLs? Like domain names. It's like, I used to collect thimbles. I think I own more domain names now than I ever owned thimbles in my whole life. Because they're exciting. Do you all attend meetups? Raise your hand if you've never been to a meetup before. Okay, cool. So there's a bunch of you who need to find your local meetups. Meetups are an amazing way to be a part of the local community. Some local WordPress meetups meet sporadically. Some meet very regularly. Some meet very frequently. Our meetup is once a month for our regular meetup and every other month for an advanced WordPress meetup. Because we discovered we had people that really wanted to go a little bit deeper into code, but when we would do that in a regular meetup, we would lose people and they drop off and not come back. So now we have two levels of meetup to meet people where they need to be. So we have regular meetup, kind of run-of-the-mill, middle of the line, and then we have a more advanced. Guess what? You have something to say. You have learned something. I don't care who you are in this room, you have learned something that other people could learn from too. Whether it was something that was a success for you or something that was a failure for you. And I'll tell you my biggest failure. And it's not easy to tell people this when you're supposed to be an expert at what you're doing. But last year, I spoke at WordCamp Montreal. And it was a 7-hour drive from my house in Rochester up to Montreal. And halfway there, I started getting texts and phone calls from customers that their sites were down. And I had them all on a shared server. And they got hacked. There were 23 sites on that shared server space, and 22 of them went down. So I'm texting them back going, well, I'm in the car on the way to Montreal, but I'll look at it tonight. So went to the speaker dinner, went back to my hotel room. Sure enough, I have a list from SiteGround telling me 900 infected files. You can't just delete infected files, because some of them are header files. Some of them are, you know, footer files and things that you can't just get rid of. So you have to go through each and every one of them, determine if it's a real file or not, replace it if it needs to be replaced, clean it up if you have to clean it up. I finished cleaning up those hacked sites at 6:30 in the morning and had to leave by 7:15 to get to WordCamp. So I slept for 45 minutes and got to WordCamp that day. I was exhausted. And I spoke at 1:30 in the afternoon. I'm told it was wonderful. I don't remember a thing. And the whole reason that I bring that up is that I needed a speaker at the next session to talk about how to fix a hacked website. And I asked if anybody had any experience or knowledge and would be willing to speak. And nobody raised their hand, nobody came forward, nobody commented. And I thought, well, I'm going to have to do some research. I'm not really sure how to research that. Guess what? I got some real firsthand research, real darn quick. And because I didn't know how to fix a hacked website at the time, and I wasn't sure what to do, I didn't do it right. So guess what happened 2 days later? 930 infected files, and I got to do it again. And so I did it the exact same way. Guess what? A week later, 960 infected files. Until I did a little more research and figured out what was going on. Found the culprit. Did you know that they will create their own admin names? So you can't just clean up the infected files. You have to make sure they didn't create an admin name that they're logging back into your site with. Silly me, I had no idea. So I started looking for different things and discovered different ways to fix that. And I, since then, had no problem because I've learned my lesson, knock on wood. However, any site is vulnerable at any time. No matter how many gates you put up, somebody has a way to hack in. So just do your due diligence. But understand that learning from people who have made mistakes is just as valuable, if not more so, than people who have had successes. I say that to let you know that you have the power to share at your local meetup. And you have something that other people might want to hear. You can lead a discussion. If you don't want to, maybe you don't want to speak, but you have really great organizational skills, so organize the meetup. You never have to open your mouth if you're willing to make sure there's cookies and there's always a place to go. So organize your meetups. So I organize the meetups in Rochester, New York. I have a great time with that. I get people to speak. I set my topics a whole year at a time and work to get people to do that because the behind-the-scenes stuff is just as important. So you can pay it forward by giving back to your community in those ways. You can pay it back WordPress deal. Believe it or not, I know it's free, doesn't make sense, but there are a lot of ways you can pay back this community. You can participate in the forums. There are people asking questions that you know the answer to. So log in, take a look and see what questions are being asked. There are ways for you to help other people solve their problems without having to stand up in front of a room full of people. Maybe that's not your thing. Maybe you'd like to be behind the keyboard or behind the screen. The forums are a great way to do that because you can just have a gravatar up there. Nobody has to know your real name even. It's whatever you make it be, and you can help other people out. You can participate in the forums. I don't do that a lot because I like being in front of you guys. I like seeing your faces. But I have answered a couple questions before that I feel very empowered with taking that. It's pretty cool. You can contribute to core. Now I will be the first person to tell you I design using themes and plugins that already exist. I can do a little CSS magic here and there, but I am not a coder. I don't know PHP, JavaScript. I think they sound like wonderful things. It's on my bucket list to learn them. It's not going to happen anytime soon. I am probably not the kind of person that's going to contribute to core code, but maybe you are. Maybe you can be the person who logs in and says, I know how to do that. I can suggest this idea. I can code it. I can help, and I can be on that team. So contributing to core is just another wonderful way that you can be involved and pay back. Maybe you can't do that either, like me. Maybe that's not your forte. Well, guess what? They need videos edited and uploaded to WordPress.tv all the time. So maybe you have the ability, following WordCamp Boston, to say, hey, I'm going to edit some of those videos and upload those to WordPress.tv. Maybe they need to closed caption that. Maybe you can add that and type up what gets said. I don't want you to have to type up mine because I talk really fast. But other people might be better at it talking slow than I am, but it's a wonderful thing to be able to contribute that way. WordPress.tv, if you're not familiar with it, WordPress.tv, almost every talk, every WordCamp, as long as the equipment works like it's supposed to, gets uploaded to WordPress.tv. Very first WordCamp Rochester we ever had, I was so excited. I had a great keynote speaker coming in, and WordCamp Orlando, I think it was Orlando or Miami, had the equipment that was supposed to come to WordCamp Rochester. And then they got hit with a humongous hurricane. It was Orlando, wasn't it? It was WordCamp. And we didn't get any video cameras. So the only video we had was from people's cell phones posting. And that's not good enough for WordPress.tv. But they could post it in some of the different forums and things like that and share with the speakers anyway what they had. Maybe you have the skills to be able to help that. There isn't always going to be WordPress.tv for every single talk, but maybe there is. And if you don't know this about WordPress.tv, you can search by topic and you can search by speaker. So if you want to learn how to build a membership website, you go to WordPress.tv and WordPress.tv. You can search for membership sites and you will find just a plethora of different topics related to building membership sites. Maybe your favorite speaker is, let's say, Matt Mullenweg, and you want to see how many times he's spoken, and you search for Matt Mullenweg on there, you're going to see every keynote address he's done. You're going to see his State of the Word addresses, and you're going to see other talks he's been involved with. So you'll be able to pull up by person, too. And it's just a wonderful way to be included and to see and to participate in. But you can also help with those videos and pay back that way. You can help organize WordCamp. So this WordCamp did not just happen automatically. It does not happen because of WordCamp Central. It happens because there are people here in Boston who said, I want to help make this happen. And those people are all volunteers. If you're a volunteer at WordCamp Boston today, raise your hand. So we got one, a couple more, two. So we got some volunteers here. Those people deserve a round of applause, first of all. Tremendous amount of work, and we don't get paid for it. Your speakers don't get paid, your volunteers, the organizers, nobody gets paid, and you're spending time and money out of your own pocket to be here. And those people are, in my opinion, the real heroes of the volunteers who make it all happen. And those are the organizers and the volunteers that do WordCamp. So the organizers, especially, meet for months and months and months to get all of that taken care of, squared away. We call each other wranglers, so the WordPress word is like, we have sponsor wranglers, speaker wranglers, venue wranglers, food. wranglers. Everybody's a wrangler. And so we need people to do those things. This, what you see here on the screen is WordCamp Rochester's first ever WordCamp. I was the lead organizer. I chose my birthday to have WordCamp. And 140 people come to our very first ever WordCamp on my birthday. And it felt like I got to celebrate with 140 friends. It was awesome. And at the end of the day, we had a party. And WordPress paid for it. I got like my 48th birthday party paid for by WordPress. And 140 of my awesome friends there. So organizing WordCamp can be a tremendous amount of fun. It's a lot of work, but it's really worthwhile. And like I said, you can volunteer at WordCamp, whether you're sitting at the registration table, whether you're taking care of social media, whether you volunteer to help make the website be what it needs to be, any of those things, following up with the sponsors and the speakers and all of the things that go into making WordCamp. We need volunteers at every camp. I think the minimum number of volunteers I've ever seen at a camp is a dozen, and it goes way, way up from there depending on the size of the camp. So volunteer to be here. You get your ticket free too, by the way, when you volunteer at camp. So there's just a little benefit to being a volunteer. You can help out at the happiness bar. So most camps have a happiness bar. Do you know what a happiness bar is? Happiness bar is where you can sit down with other people and they help you with any questions that you have. So you want to know how to fix XYZ, hit up the happiness bar and people will help you. So you don't have to officially sign up for almost anything to work at a happiness bar. You can just sit down there and help other people out. That's one way of just giving back, helping one other person while you sit there at a happiness bar. First time I ever sat down at a happiness bar as a quote-unquote expert, I was terrified. I had imposter syndrome like you would not believe. I was absolutely 100% convinced that the first question would be, I have a PHP problem. And I would have been like, I'm sorry, I think there's a 12-step program for that. But it wasn't. It was, I need to change this button from green to this other blue. Can you help me? And I was like, aha! CSS, I know this. I can help this person. And I was able to help them. And then the second person sat down and said, I have a PHP problem. I said, I think that guy over there can help. Because he could. I heard him talking. He knew code. So you're able to kind of help the people you can. And if you can't help somebody, it's not like, ha, huh, she called herself an expert. No, of course not, because we're just there to help one another out. So sit down at the happiness bar and see if you can help people that way. Speak at WordCamps. You would be surprised. I know there was a time in my life, I know it's hard to believe, where I was the shyest person in the room. If somebody had said, someday you're going to stand at the podium or sit at the podium and give a talk, I would have been like, I have no idea who you think I am, but I am not that girl. I overcame that, obviously, and I love sharing. And you know why? Because I think I have something that you all can take with you when you leave the room. I tie a bunch of different talks, and hopefully, by the time you leave, you say, I didn't know that. I feel empowered. Whatever it is that when you leave the room today, you say, I think I can do more. I think there's something I can do to help other people. So speak at a WordCamp. It's great. You have something to share. I promise there's something that you do or you know that other people can benefit from. You can participate in a hackathon. Has anybody ever participated in a hackathon? Just a couple people. That's great. So there's all kinds of different hackathons you can do. This year, we did the very first hackathon ever in Rochester. We had 17 people come together and build websites for three Rochester area nonprofits. They started with nothing at 8 o'clock in the morning. At 5 o'clock, they were presenting to each other their WordPress websites. We had outside people come in at the end of the day, watch the presentations, and choose a winner based on a couple different criteria, and that nonprofit organization got a $100 gift card to Amazon to help their nonprofit go a little bit further. Every single one of those 17 people paid $10 to come do that. We provided pizza, I got some sponsorships, I got the space donated by a local college, and we spent 9 hours that day creating websites for nonprofits who were so, so grateful and now have a piece of real estate on the website on the internet where they can raise money and raise awareness for their causes. There's nothing like it. And there were people at each table. So if you look at the guy in the center there, he is a self-proclaimed WordPress groupie. He comes to every single one of our meetups, every single one. He comes to all of our WordCamps. He has never logged into a WordPress site in his entire life and would have no idea how to do it. But he wants to support the community. So he comes. That day, they said, we need images for this, that, and the other. He was the image guy. He was on Unsplash. He was on Morgfile. He was on those places where you get free images for your WordPress website, for any website. And he was downloading and sharing those because somebody needed to do that job too. So we had people at every table ranging from, I've never logged into a WordPress website, to I'm a developer, and everybody in between. And that's how we were able to do three of those, because it wasn't five developers, five designers, and five people who had no clue. It was evenly distributed. And we were able to accomplish a lot. Those are the people. I was the 18th person, I think, in the room, and I didn't contribute in any way except to continue to help and run things back and forth. So those are the people I organized that hackathon. I have a blog post somewhere about organizing a hackathon. If you want to know, I will share that with you later. I'm running out of time, so I'm going to keep going. You can build a free website and give it away for a nonprofit. Once a year, I give away a nonprofit website. I build it for a local nonprofit and able to keep them and help sustain them. I host them, I do whatever they need, and I keep them going. That's one way for me to be able to give back. You can build a WordPress theme. You can build an app. There's an app out there for WordCamps. You can build a plugin. You can find bugs. There's lots of different ways that you can be involved in WordPress without necessarily knowing how to do a bunch of different things. You don't have to know everything to be a successful contributor and be able to give back to the community. But I warn you, there is a side effect to being involved in the WordPress community. First is we have fun. This is the speaker dinner last year. They were laughing their heads off. It was a great time. We had it at a brewery. We had taco bar set up. It wasn't anything fancy, and they were having a blast. So we have a ton of fun doing meetups, doing speaker dinners, doing everything related to WordPress. Make it great friendships. I have friends in the WordPress community. I'm moving on Tuesday, and the local WordPress community, three people are showing up at my house just because they know me through WordPress, with a van and a trailer and people power to help move my furniture from one location to the other. That blew my mind. I actually cried when they said they were coming. It's like, I only know you through the meetup, and you said you're coming to help me. That's, to me, amazing. And that's what our WordPress community is all about. We get clients from it, right? So I have contributed in a lot of positive ways. I give back a lot, but I get a lot, too. I have gotten so many clients because they Google Michelle, or they Google WordPress Rochester, and they find me. And they hire me to build their websites. That's phenomenal. But even more than that, I got a good job out of it. So here I am on the speaking circuit last year. I meet these people from a company called Give, and I say to them, if you're ever hiring, I'm looking for a full-time job. Boom, here I am. Been working for them since January. I have a job, and guess what? I got to hire somebody else. So now, it's just growing. I'm able to spread that love. We get happiness. There's so much happiness involved in this community. There's so much involvement. So many ways that you can interact with one another in such a positive way. And I get the warm fuzzies. I know that's a little cheesy, but I do. I get the warm fuzzies whenever I'm able to help somebody and make their site better. So how do we get started? Join your local meetup. If you're not part of your local meetup, find it. Go to meetup.com and just type in the search bar, WordPress. You will find your local meetup. Attend WordCamp. So you're here today. Go to some more. Come back next year. Guess what? Providence, Rhode Island has one that's not far from here. Portland, Maine has one. Rochester, New York is only a 6-hour drive. Come to our WordCamp. There's WordCamps everywhere. There's lots of ways you can get involved. Go to coworking. Start coworking. Participate in the forums. Help somebody else, even if it's one person with one problem. Tweet about WordPress and how awesome it is. And ask other people for help, because asking for help enables them to help you too. And so being somebody who needs something is not a bad thing. That's another way to be involved in the community, is to ask for help. Because together we make the WordPress community the amazing place that it is. It's not me. It's not the people I work for. It's all of us. We are all part of that community, and we make it the great place that it is. I'm Michelle Ames. I'm the head of customer success for Give. You can reach me, Michelle at givewp.com. My Twitter, my SlideShare, my WordPress.org is all Michelle Ames. So you can find me there. You can find my... Follow me on Twitter. I love it. It's fantastic. And the last thing I'll say is I just wrote a book called A Good Firm Handshake and Other Essential Business Tips. The first two people people to tweet me amazing questions about anything WordPress related will get a copy of my book mailed to them. So if you're interested in that, tweet me later, tweet me now, tweet me whatever, I love tweets, and hit me up. But we do have a couple minutes for questions. We ask if you do have questions, we want to make sure that we catch everything on WordPress TV. So there's a microphone in the middle, so if you could, if you have a question, otherwise we're good. We have 5 minutes for questions, so if anybody has one, I'm here. If you don't, I consider myself amazingly successful and I told you anything you ever needed to know. Okay, so the question is how to fix a hacked website? That is a talk, that's probably a 4-hour talk in and of itself, but I will tell you that it, the really quick version is go through every single file, they tell you it's infected, and then look for more. Because it's not just the 930 that they send you, there's more out there that they didn't discover either. How many of you have ever looked in the CGI bin, right? So you set up WordPress sites, there's a CGI bin, and it's always empty, right? Guess what? Wasn't empty this time, that's where the virus sat. So make sure you check everything. And look for those additional... So there's lots of ways that infections can happen, and there's a million ways that you can clean it up. I couldn't possibly go into all of them right now, but I'll be at my table out in the main section. If you want to stop by, I'm happy to answer questions there too.
Okay. And was it Fluffy that helped you, or you
nope.
To go...
I went through file by file by file. Took a while. Yeah. Other questions? I saw somebody in.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Thank
you. One of the first points you made was how massive the user base is for WordPress.
Yes.
And its potential to leverage good simply by that. Are there examples of doing good outside of doing good within the WordPress community that you can hold up to those of us who might be trying to leverage that one third of the internet impact potential?
I'm not sure I understood the questions. Can you say that again?
So, the user base for WordPress is phenomenally large.
Yes.
How can people use that as an organizing base to do good beyond
gotcha.
The WordPress community?
Beyond the WordPress community? I think that building websites that reach outside of the WordPress community is a great way to start that. So, nonprofit WordPress, nonprofit sites for WordPress is a great way to do that. Hackathons, being involved in that. Pulling in nonprofits, I think, is a great way to kind of spread that for good. I participated in a hackathon once that was all about startups. So it wasn't nonprofit, but it was a WordPress hackathon, and by the end of the day, 10 startup companies had brand new websites. And so that's another way to just pull people into the community by supplying them something that they need to be successful. That's one idea, or two. Any other questions? Yes.
I really like your idea of the building the community with skills, not specifically or, you know, building a developer, but also like somebody, a gentleman who is downloading all the images. Do you have any other tasks that we can sort of take away from there and go back to some communities where there are a lot of underprivileged kids who can have, say, probably claim that they are part of the school website?
So where they're not logging into the site necessarily, but where they're contributing in other ways? Sure, absolutely. So as you said, one of the ways is to find those images and things like that. Another way is to provide other content. So let's look at other, let's say we're doing a website for a startup. Let's look at some competition across the world, some people that do the same thing, and start to build some content based on what we see. Not stealing content, not plagiarizing anything, but getting ideas from other people about what could be included, and then assigning the task of writing good content. Thinking about those SEO keywords that we want to put in there too, and making sure that those things are all included. So that's a great way to get people started thinking about things besides code, besides being logged in, is what else makes a good website? Images and content is what really makes a good website, right? Absolutely. I think we have one more question and then we're out of time. Very good. So we're good. So I'm here all weekend. I am out at my table out in the sponsor area, so feel free to stop by if you have more questions or ideas that I can take. Thank you so much. You've been a great audience, and I appreciate you. So I'm going to take some pictures of my sunglasses real quick before the next speaker comes.